Okay, let's get started. So, Jos, my colleague, submitted this talk here. Yesterday I had a look, and basically the topic is to talk about 200 apps from Nextcloud, and I have 15 minutes of time. So I don't really know how to do that. So this will be a little bit fast. I tried to cover like 50. 200, it's a bit crazy for 15 minutes. So if you're interested in apps and extensions and new additional features for Nextcloud, I encourage you to take a look at our app store. We have this apps.nextcloud.com where all these community apps are listed. It's not really a store. I mean, it's called App Store, but it's, of course, everything is open source, free software, so it's for free. But this is a repository where the community uploads extensions and apps for Nextcloud. And I want to go through 50 of them now. So the first is something very basic, it's a PDF viewer. So this is a way to view PDFs. It's actually very nice because you can see the chapters and the table of contents on the side. The second thing is very popular is the photo gallery. That's a nice photo gallery where every time you upload a photo, there's automatically a gallery generated and you can share it directly with your friends and family on the side. Then there's a lot of functionality around two-factor authentication. So we support two-factor authentication with a hardware token, with a YubiKey, for example, or with an SMS, or with a push notification to our clients, lots of different ways. A cool new app, cool new feature is called Suspicious Login Detection. That's a cool new feature of the latest version that's actually using machine learning. Yeah, I know, buzzword, yeah. But it's actually using a neural network to check your login behavior. And if there's a login from a user who is usually not logging from China in the middle of the night with an unknown device, then it can actually detect this in the neural network here and give you a warning or block the account. Then there's an app called Group Folders, because usually sharing of files and folders between users works on a user-to-user basis. But here's also a way where you can have like global shares, similar to Samba shares or Windows shares. And the administrator can create shares for groups of users, how you know it from the normal file servers. And we support access control lists there, where you can say this group has write permissions, this other has read permissions in a subfolder, this user has additional permission, and so on. Then there is search, of course. We have integration for Elasticsearch, so you can actually search in the content of all your files, your PDF, your Word files, and everything else directly from inside Nextcloud. There's a workflow feature where, depending on certain events, let's say a certain user from a certain LDAP group uploads a special file with a special MIME type in a special folder at a special time from a special device, then automatically something is triggered, like conversion to a PDF file or external script is called, which does some analysis in lots of different ways. File access control is another app where you can define as an administrator different policies. You can say, well, our users in the marketing group should not be able to share Excel files over 5 megabytes to IP addresses from China in the middle of the night if the file is tagged with important or stuff like that. You can actually model this kind of policies. There's some integration into Outlook or Thunderbird. So if you use one of those mail clients, you can basically automatically attach a very big file to your email. If you click send, it's automatically uploaded to your Nextcloud. A share link is generated and put into the file. It's very handy. Then there are a lot of groupware features. That's a very rich calendar and an email client and contacts management. They can also use one of our most popular features. Task management, there's a task app where you can create different tasks, also share this with others, and they're also syncable and accessible from all your devices, from iOS, Android, Mac, Windows, Linux. There are also clients and connectors for that. Then there's a Kanban board. You might know Trello or some other solutions. So there's a similar Kanban board for Nextcloud, of course, again, completely free software and running on your servers. And a cool feature we released like a few weeks ago is that you can connect this Kanban board to a chat channel or to a shared folder or some other things like a shared calendar. So you can basically group these things together into projects. Then there's integration into Mastodon. So if you want to basically turn your Nextcloud server into a Mastodon federated node for federated social networking, actually can interact with Mastodon. Every user of your Nextcloud can use this as an account. There's an app for synchronizing your SMS and your messages from your phone to your Nextcloud server. So you want to use the Nextcloud server to back up your SMS, for example, from your Android phones. It's a very nice app that synchronizes this automatically. If you synchronize MP3 files, if you synchronize your music collection, then there's a very nice app where you can use this to listen to your music. And it's actually very nice in advance. It fetches cover art and fetches all kind of metadata. So you can use this as a music player, very similar as you know it from Spotify and some other services, but this is running on your machine with your MP3 files. If you have a GPS file, like a GFX file, maybe you do some hiking and you track your route, you can use these kind of files to visualize your data in Nextcloud. You know this from other services too, but again, here running on your own machine. If you want to track your movement automatically inside Nextcloud too, we can have this too. There's a very nice Android app where you can which sends your location automatically all the time to your Nextcloud server. So you can store your route if you're hiking, for example. It's very nice if you want to see where you're going and how far you went and how high you climbed. But of course, not as other services. This stays on your machine and it's secure. There's a way where an administrator can send push notifications to all users or to certain groups. You can do announcements like, hey, there's a maintenance window or something else. There are actually two apps for mind mapping. So this is a screenshot of one. You can very nice mind mapping, and again, running on your own machine. If you want to enable other users to create an account on your Nextcloud server, there's an app where you can have self-registration. So you can enable this and then, I don't know, send a link around in your soccer club or something, and then everybody can create their own account if they want to. There's a news reader, so you can actually read your RSS news in Nextcloud, and there are also mobile apps where you can access them from your phones. There's a vector drawing application. Draw.io is very nice. You can do all kinds of vector graphics inside your Nextcloud. There's a way to configure external sites. That's a very nice feature where you have all kinds of other applications in your company maybe or in your university. You can basically add entries to your navigation there. And the cool thing is that it also shows up on your clients. So in iOS and Android, Mac, Windows, Linux clients, there are automatically buttons popping up to these sites. So you can use this to basically create like shortcuts to your other web application for your users. There's a way to do password management. There are actually several different apps to do password management. This is one of it, and it can be used with plugins in your browsers. This is another one. Let me see if the video works. Yeah. You can unlock your password file, your key file, and then you have all your accounts. And it's using strong encryption. It's actually very nice. Then there's a view for DCOM files. This is something you probably don't use. This is more for medical specialists. If you're in a hospital and you do some kind of analysis of data, then you can actually view them inside Nextcloud itself. There are a ton of different note-taking apps. This is just one of it. In this case, your notes are like basically here visualized as some kind of post-its, but there are all kinds of different note-taking apps there. It's a Markdown editor. It's very popular. So if you write down Markdown files, I do this all the time, you can actually render them in a nice way and view them inside Nextcloud. The next app is very cool, I think. It's very unique. It's called sent by mail, exactly. So you can connect your IMAP account to this app, and then every attachment you get by mail automatically shows up in this folder in Nextcloud. So you basically have a folder where all the attachments you ever get by mail are listed. I find this very, very handy. There's a ransomware protection app, so where basically Nextcloud detects if some suspicious files are synchronized. So if your machine or one of the machines of your users is are hacked, and it starts to synchronize like encrypted files, it's automatically protected, sends out warnings to you and to the administrator, and you can roll back to the old version. So this protects against ransomware. If you listen to web radio, there's a web radio player. You can see it's really an endless stream of crazy ideas. This is, I'm very happy that our community developed so many cool things. You can, yeah, actually listen to web radio inside Nextcloud. This is a Pulse app. So if you know Doodle, for example, there's something like Doodle in Nextcloud, and Doodle has, of course, the problem that while it's running on centralized in a server that you might not really trust. So there's a Doodle alternative directly inside Nextcloud where you can have different polls and you can enable them for certain groups and you have comments or not. So it's actually quite nice and powerful. If you use XMPP or Jabber for chat, there's a chat app for that where you can have these nice chat windows directly inside Nextcloud. If you work a lot with bookmarks and maybe you want to share bookmarks with other people, there's a bookmark syncing app. It has integration into the common browsers and you can actually share the bookmarks also with other users. It also looks very nice in my opinion. PDF conversion, you can say that if a certain file has a certain tag uploaded from a certain device at a certain time, then it's automatically created, converted to a PDF, and maybe the original file is deleted or kept. So it's actually very handy to automate some processes. Maybe you know one of those cool new 360-degree cameras. That is cool cameras from Samsung and others. You can put them into a room and creates actually a 3D image of everything. There's a viewer for that in Nextcloud, so you can watch a look at your photos directly from inside Nextcloud. There's your weather app. You can look at your weather if you want to. Again, data stays on your machine. That's a very cool new app. It's very new. This is for expense tracking. So you can actually track your expenses and your income and have different categories and different users, and you can have a nice overview over all your expenses. And again, this is data you want to protect, of course, so this stays on your server. Let me see if this works. Yes. There's a way to convert video files directly inside Nextcloud. So that's very, very handy. I mean, you can use FFmpeg on the command line if you want, or you just install this plugin and you can do it directly in the menu. If you use a file system on your Nextcloud server that supports snapshots like ButterFS or ZFS, you can actually use those snapshots inside Nextcloud automatically. So there are versions of a file available. And there are not copies. I mean, if you use a file system like X4, which can't do that, they're actually normal copies. But if you have a modern file system, there are real snapshots on the file system layer, and you can use that. If you're running this as some kind of service provider, of course, you have to follow the GDPR regulations. And for that, we have a terms of service app, where we can then say that every user who logs in first has to like approve the terms of service and follow some other rules. You can convert RAW files if you're a photographer like me automatically inside Nextcloud. So this screenshot is a bit stupid, right? Everything is grayed out. The reason for that is this is actually a Vereins management software. Like this is if you have a soccer club or something, and you can manage your members and some other events. It's also a very new app from our community where you can actually manage your soccer club or your something else inside Nextcloud. If you just want to publish a very small website for some special purpose, you just want to publish like something for your birthday party or wedding, or maybe you're a scientist and you want to publish some scientific data, there's something called Pico CMS. It's very nice. You just put some markdown files into subfolders, press the button, and then it generates a website for you where you can actually navigate this around. If you want to unpack a tar file or zip file, you can actually also do this in the menu directly. With this app, you have this extract button where you can extract the file there. Then at the end, of course, we have the little bit more complex apps. This is Nextcloud Talk, which is a chat and video conferencing app. So here you have the chat here. There are different groups chats, as you might know it from Slack and other solutions. You have your chat channels there. And of course, they have the dedicated mobile apps, iOS and Android, also with push notifications. You get a push notification if someone mentions you in a chat. And of course, you can also turn this into a video call. So this is actually very nice. This is like complete open source, complete self-hosted, WebRTC standards-based without any plugins. You don't need any browser plugins directly in your browser. And again, there are mobile apps for iOS and Android where you can have group calls on your phone. And again, also push notifications. So if someone calls you, your actually phone rings. And this is very unique. It doesn't really exist anywhere else because this is only running on your machine, completely open source. And of course, this can be combined with the document editing. Here we have the integration is in LibreOffice Online, a Collabora Online, for example, where you can edit different documents here. And in the sidebar, you have a chat channel and a video call with the people who are editing the same document at the same time. I'm a little bit proud about that because this doesn't really exist anywhere else. I mean, if you look at Skype for Business from Microsoft or Google Hangouts, they can only do this in different windows. So you have to then put one window here and the other window there. But this kind of integration here, it's actually better than what you get from the big proprietary companies. Okay, I think I made it. 50 apps in 15 minutes. I think that's also very important because I think we have lunch now, but maybe still some time for some questions. Or maybe you're all hungry. I am. Okay, thanks a lot.